There's music here tonight.
Good evening and welcome to Caffe Lena. Thanks for watching this live stream production from Saratoga Springs, New York. These live streams are made possible by the generous support of the Sarah B. Folk Charitable Fund and by our community of subscribers. Special thanks to our Virtuoso level subscribers and lifetime Caffe Lena members. By buying a ticket for this performance, you're supporting independent music and the mission of our historic nonprofit venue. Enjoy your front row seats for this show, live from Caffe Lena.
All right, good evening and welcome to Caffe Lena. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. This is a group that made their way to the national stage a few years ago when they were finalists on America's Got Talent. And it's always a little bit surreal to have them up here on our stage at Caffe Lena with a concert harp and a cello, and they're just larger than life arrangements. So I'd like to invite you all to just join us in celebrating the joy of the season and just be totally transported tonight. Thank you once again for being here, and please welcome Sons of Serendip.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Stopping, and I've bought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Thank you all so much. We are Sons of Serendip, finalists in season 9 of America's Got Talent, and contestants on the first season of America's Got Talent, the champions. Are you guys ready to rock? Well, if you're ready to rock, you came to the wrong show. We have a harp, a cello, a keyboard. Y'all are ready to rock. Nonetheless, we are so grateful for this opportunity to be back here in Caffe Lena, in Saratoga Springs. You know, that last song that we sang was one that is really normally a great song to perform, except for when there is actually a winter storm on the way. It's like, please. How many of you saw us the last time that we were here? All right, awesome. How many of you, this is your first time seeing us perform? Awesome, wonderful, well, welcome. And for those of you who are tuning in virtually, we are grateful for you all being here as well. And we will do just a quick little Q&A at some point during the concert. And so if you have questions virtually, feel free to write them on our Facebook page, and we'll get those questions. But yeah, whatever questions you all have, just, you know, we'll have them. We'll save them for a little bit later in the concert, and yeah, and we'll connect in that way. One thing that we like to do at the beginning of all of our concerts, we would love for you all to take a look at the people around you and tell the people around you, it is so good to see you here tonight. Perfect. Because every moment that we have to share with one another is a gift, and we don't take that for granted. Are you all ready? Are you ready? All right, wonderful. So tonight is going to be a number of songs, holiday songs that you have already heard, and many of them you already know and love, and we're trying to do them in a way that hopefully is fresh for you all this holiday season and during this concert. And there is one thing that I wanted to bring up. Yes. Oh, yes, 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 yes. So I just wanted to give a shout out to one of the folks that showed up today. Daryl Belch, where are you? Daryl, awesome, wonderful. So Daryl and I have known each other for about 20 years now. We came from the same a cappella group, this a cappella fraternity that we're both a part of. And so I just wanted to give a shout out to Daryl. Just give him a round of applause for being here. He's one of my singing brothers, and so I'm just really grateful that you were able to make it out here tonight. The holiday season brings up a number of different memories. And for me, it brings up a memory of the very first gift that I ever got my mother for Christmas. I was 8 years old, and I had saved up all my allowance money, and I was so excited to get my mom the very first gift from me. And I was excited because I really wanted this gift to be so perfect so that she would love me more than my brothers. So I told my dad about this plan. I was like, I want to get my mom a gift for Christmas. And so he took me out searching for the perfect gift for my mother. We went searching and searching and searching. A bracelet? No, that's not good enough for my mother. A bowling ball? No, that's not good enough for my mother. After searching high and low and searching and searching, I finally found the perfect gift for my mother. It was a golden necklace. And I remember when I bought this golden necklace, I ran home I ran into my room as soon as we got home, and I wrapped it in newspaper because I couldn't afford normal wrapping paper. And I put, "To Mom, love, Santa's little helper." Aw, I know. And I didn't sleep much that night or the following nights up until Christmas Day. Christmas Day comes along, and I ran under the tree, and I grabbed the gift, and I give it to my mom. I was like, Mom, open the gift for me. It's for me. And she looks at it, opens it up, puts it around her neck, and I looked up at her, and I was like, wow, Mom, you look so beautiful with that golden necklace. And she looked at me, and then she gave me the biggest hug and kiss and said, I love you so much. And I said, more than my brothers? Another story. So then she wore that golden necklace every day. And every day I would look up at her and just say, wow, Mom, you look so beautiful with that golden necklace. And that lasted for about a week. And then I never saw it again. But I knew that my mother had put that golden necklace somewhere safe where it could be passed on from generation to generation to generation. So leading up to our holiday tours that we were doing, I called her and I was like, Mom, do you remember the first gift that I got you for Christmas? She's like, yeah. Do you remember that golden necklace and how beautiful you looked in it? She's like, yeah, of course. And I said, well, Mom, whatever happened to that golden necklace? Where is that secret place that you put it where it could be passed on from generation to generation to generation? And she goes, Micah, I threw that away. I was like, Mom, how could you? She's like, it turned my neck green. I thought you got it from Macy's. And I was like, no, Mom, I got it from a Macy's parking lot. A guy had it in his jacket. But it's okay. Because I know that someone reached in that trash and found that golden necklace. And it's now being passed on from generation to generation to generation in someone else's family. So yes, exactly. So that's the story of the golden necklace. We're going to continue on with the music. This next song is Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
Golden days, happy golden days.
if the fates allow. But till then, we'll have to muddle through somehow.
Thank you.